Good morning, children. Now we are going to start our new chapter, that is triangle and its properties. Okay? Yes, sir. We are perfect with lines and angles now. Now, to using that lines and angles by given measurements, we are going to construct our triangles and also squares, rectangles. How they in triangles there are different types of triangles. Equilateral triangle, isosceles triangle and scalene triangle. How they are going to be measured, how they are going to be identified, yes, what are the identification for each and every angle, yes, we are going to learn in this lesson. First we go for key concepts. Okay, now triangle can be classified according to properties of their sides and angles. Based on sides, triangles are of three types. Yes, triangles are of three types now, based on lines and angles. Based on lines and angles, using this, based on lines and angles, we are going to find the triangles. Yes, triangles. These triangles can be classified into three types. They are three types. They are, what are they? Three types. What are they? First one is equilateral triangle. Second one is isosceles triangle. And third one is scalene triangle. Yes, the triangle symbol is will be denoted like this one. Okay, and equilateral triangle, scalene triangle, and isosceles triangle. How the equilateral triangle is formed, how the isosceles triangle is formed, and also how the scalene triangle is formed, we are going to learn. Okay? Now, equilateral triangle. First, we go for equilateral triangle. An equilateral triangle in which all sides are equal is called equilateral triangle. In triangle ABC, AB equal to BC equal to CA, also angle A equal to angle B equal to angle C. In an equilateral triangle, each angle is equal to 60 degrees. See, equilateral triangle, we are going to learn about equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle will be like this. That means all sides of equilateral triangle will be equal. And angle A, angle B, it is represented. The angles are represented like this. Angle A, angle B, and angle C are angles of a equilateral triangle. Where all triangles which is equal to, the angle which is equal to 60 degrees, the angle which is equal to 60 degrees is called equilateral triangle. That means all sides are equal. Okay? Understood about equilateral triangle? Where sides, this one side, this one side, that is AB one side, BC one side, and CA is also one side. Okay? Now coming to the isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle in which two sides are equal is called an isosceles triangle. In PQR, for example, here isosceles triangle, the triangle will represent like this, where other two sides will be equal, only one side will be different. Other two sides will be equal, other two sides will be different. Here, the angle, all sides here, for example, this is PQR, that is PQ is equals to PR, but where you compare with the QR is different, it is not equal. So, where other two sides are equal, only two sides are equal in a triangle is called, said to be isosceles triangle. The non-equal side is an isosceles, may be taken as a base of the triangle. Every time the non-equal side, which is compared to the other sides, which is taken as a base of the triangle, base of the triangle, okay? That is nothing but isosceles triangle. Scalene triangle. Now coming to the scalene triangle. Scalene triangle, the triangle in which no two sides are equal is called scalene triangle in triangle BAD. See, here, coming to the scalene triangle, Here no sides are equal. Here all sides are unequal means not equal. There is no sides will be equal means all sides will be different. So that is said to be unscalar triangle. Okay. Now based on angles, triangles can be classified into again three types. Now based on these triangles and angles are classified into again three types. Okay. Now see. Acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle triangle and right angle isosceles triangle. See, based on these triangles, based on angles, triangles can be classified. Again, these will be classified into three types, five types. See, three types they are. Based on angles, triangles can be classified into three types. Based on triangles, angles can be classified into three types. That is a obtuse angle and right angle triangle and right angle isosceles triangle. Now in these, how should identify the right angle and also acute angle and also isosceles triangle, how it can be identified? Yes, these how can be identified. Now acute angle, the triangle in which all three sides angles are acute is called an acute angle. Where acute angle is said to be where all angles is equal to means which is above 60 degrees and below 90 degrees. Below above 60 degrees and below 90 degrees, which is said to be the angles will be all equal in acute angle. It is nothing but acute angle. Okay. Now obtuse angle. A triangle in which one angle is obtuse in is called an angle triangle. Now in obtuse angle, it is said to be one angle will be obtuse. That means that will be equal to 90 degrees. That is equal to above 90 degrees and below 180 degrees is nothing but obtuse angle. Yes. Now right angle triangle, the angle which is exactly equal to 90 degrees is said to be right angled triangle. Yes, right angle triangle. And right angled isosceles triangle, the triangle in which one angle is right angle and other two sides are equal at right angle triangle. So in right angle in isosceles triangle can be told that one angle will be 90 degrees and other sides will be same. It is said to be right angle isosceles triangle. Understood about this, how the triangles have angles are formed, how many types are there? Yes. Now we will learn the family chart, that is family of triangles. That is, we learn about flowchart. Flowchart. That is family of triangles. That is flowchart. That is flowchart. Now, triangle. This is triangle. This triangles are divided into two types. That is based on one. It is on based on sides. Another it is on based on angles. Based on angles. These triangles are divided into two types. It is based on sides and another one it is based on angles. Based on angles are divided into again two types. They are equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle and isosceles. Isosceles triangle and scalene triangle. And based on angles, it can be divided into again three types. Yes, that is acute triangle, obtuse triangle, and right angled isosceles triangle. Right angled isosceles triangle. The triangle is divided into three types. We have learned how should identify the equilateral triangle and isosceles triangle and also scalene triangle based on sides. Now, based on sides, equilateral triangle, all sides are equal. It's said to be equilateral triangle. Based on sides in isosceles triangle, only two sides are equal. One will be another, and it is taken as a base. It is said to be isosceles triangle. And scalene triangle. Scalene triangle is said to be all sides will be different. It is said to be an scalene triangle. Yes, it is based on sides. So, based on sides can be divided into three types. They are equilateral, isosceles, and also scalene. Everyone remember that. Okay. Now, coming to the based on angles in the triangle, it can be said to be an acute angle triangle and also obtuse triangle and angle and also right angle triangle. Yes. Now, these triangles can be identified and also acute angle. Acute angle will be all sides are equal, which angles will be equal, that is above 60 degrees. Yes. Now, obtuse angles below 90 degrees, above 90 degrees, and also which is equal to at the right angle. The angle will be right angle, that is the right, the angle which is equal to 90 degrees, equal to right angle, and also other two sides will be equal, one angle will be 90 degrees. It is said to be at right angle isosceles triangle also. Don't think that it is another angle. It is also equal to the based on angles only. But which is the other two sides equal? No, it is based on isosceles angle triangle. Okay. Now, for example, now I am giving equilateral triangle means all sides are equal. I told. Means for example, one side I am taking 4 cm, other sides are also I am taking 4 cm. So, all 4 cm means on all other sides I am taking 4 cm only. So, it is said to be an equal all sides. So, it is an equilateral triangle. Yes, sir. Another example for isosceles triangle. Other two sides I am taking 4 cm and then other base has a centimeter. So it can be easily identified. Here other two sides are equal, next side it is unequal. So it is said to be an isosceles triangle. No, scalene triangle. All, for example, 5 cm, 3 cm, 6 cm. I am taking different centimeters on all sides. By observing the diagram only, we can say that all sides are unequal. So it is said to be a scalene triangle. Yes. Now, acute angle. Yes. Now, here the angle is 60 degrees, angle is 70 degrees, angle is 30 degrees. Yes. Now, here the angles above 30 degrees and below 60 yes, all sides are equal. Then it is said to be an acute angle. Then where right angle triangle, obtuse angle. Above, this is 110 degrees and also this is 30 degrees, it is 40 degrees. Where, which is above 90 degrees, just below 180 degrees, it is said to be a obtuse triangle angle. Yes, sir. Now, right angle triangle, it is exactly which is equals to 90 degrees and other two sides are equal. It's said to be isosceles. That is right angle isosceles triangle. Okay? Understood? Now, relation between sides of a triangle. Now, coming to the chapter, coming to the exercise 1, okay? Everyone understood the about the triangles and angles and also? Yes, everyone understood, no? Now, let us see the exercise 1. If it is it possible to have a triangle? Exercise 1, Mama, everyone open. First one. Yes. Is it possible to have a triangle with the following sides? Yes, sir. I'm going to do the first sum, Mama, remaining you. 3 centimeters, 4 centimeters, and 5 centimeters. Yes, sir. Here, yes, a triangle can be formed with these three sides here. Because C, 3 plus 4, adding 1, this is 2, this is 3, 1 plus 2, yes, again 2 plus 3, again 3 plus 1, yes, these are the, we have to add which is equal to, which is greater than other equal, we have to say that they are equilateral triangle, isosceles triangle and also other two sides. Then, that 1 plus 2, what is 3 centimeters plus 4 centimeters? Here, 2 plus 3, 4 centimeters plus 5 centimeters. And 3 plus 1, 3 centimeters plus 5 centimeters. 3 plus 1. So, 3 plus 4, 7 centimeters. 9 centimeters. Then, 8 centimeters. Here, then, now with these sides and triangles cannot be formed. Yes, a triangle can be formed with these sides. Here, it can, the length of two sides of a triangle are 6 centimeters and with all these possible, the length of third side. The possible length of the third side must be greater than, less than the first one. So, here, the triangles can be told that yes, a triangle can be formed. Yes, these are above is greater than greater than 5, greater than 3, greater than 4, other two sides. Yes, which is equal to other two sides. It is said to be here if it is with all sides are equal. Hence it is forms a triangle. Okay? Understood? Now, exercise 2 from the day 2 marks. In a triangle ABC, D is the midpoint of BC. Nana. From this, they have given the diagram. We have to identify which is the midpoint and also which is the median of the following. Okay, na? exercise 2. Now, here they have given a diagram. From this diagram, we have to identify the what is the median, what is the midpoint. A, B, D, C. This is a E. E triangle. A, B, C triangle. A, B, C in triangle. A, B, C in triangle. A, B, C. From this, AD is median. AD is median. Yes, and other they said to find midpoint. D is the midpoint of BC. AD is median and BC is the AE is angle. AE is angle. Yes, which cuts in the middle? That is median. That is midpoint. And here AD is which is cutting exactly to the midpoint. It is acting as a altitude. Here this is D is median and AE is altitude. Now name the triangle in which two altitudes of the triangles are of two sides of equal. In a right angle triangle, the sides containing the right angles are two altitudes. That is, we will write the example now. Second one. In right angle triangle, the two sides of are altitudes. How it can be represented? Like this. CA. Here, which is in the L shape, that is equal to 90 degrees. Now, here, two other angles. Angles are altitude. Here, in angle CAT or triangle also. In triangle CAT, angle A is 90 degrees. And we call here CP has altitude. CP has altitude. Okay? That we have to show. And next one in exercise 2. They have given the triangle. From that we have to identify the value of x. We have to find the value of x. Yes, here they have given triangle like this. Here x degree.